Hi everyone, I hope you are doing great. Today I'm going to speak about two functions, SUMIF and SUMIFS. These two functions are simple but very practical. I bet you will be agree with me at the end of the video. So let's jump in. I have a clothing company that is active in three different countries. In this list, you can see the sale amount for different products. I want to calculate how much shirt I have sold in all the countries, but using the sum function is a little difficult because the shirt items are not written in order in the list. In this situation, we usually use the SUMIF function. This function checks the list if there is the shirt in the list as the sale amount to the summation. So I type equal SUMIF. In the argument, you have to first select the range that your criteria are in it. In this case, I'm looking for the shirt and it is in this range, comma. Here I have to select my criteria. My criteria is shirt, so I select this cell, comma. And in the last part of the argument, you have to select the summation range. So I select the sale amount range and press enter. Excel automatically calculates the sale amount for the shirts in all countries. From drop-down list, you can see the sale amount for different items. But what if I want to calculate the sale amount for the shirt in Germany? Can I do that with the SUMIF function? No, you can't do that, because in SUMIF function, you can only define one criteria. If you have more than one criteria, you have to use the SUMIFS function. In this example, we have the same list and this time I want to calculate the sale amount for the male underwear for each country separately. For that, I have to use the SUMIFS function. I type equal SUMIFS. The argument is a little different from the SUMIF function. In this function, you have to first select the summation range, so I select the sale amount, comma. In the criteria range 1, you need to select the range that your first criteria are in it. Male underwear is my first criteria, so I select this range, comma. Now, I have to select the first criteria, comma. Germany is my second criteria, so I select the range that Germany is in it, comma. And I select Germany as my second criteria and press enter. Excel calculates the sale amount for male underwear in Germany correctly. But what about other countries? For solving this problem, I have to define these countries as criteria. So I double click on the formula and I click on the criteria 2 in the argument. And instead of Germany, I select all countries and press OK. Do you see that? Excel automatically calculates the results for all countries. I want to edit my formula. I want to calculate only the online shopping. Right now, Excel is showing me the online and in-person sale amount, but I want to see only the online sale. For that, you need to add another criteria to the formula. So double-click on the formula and at the end type comma. Criteria range 3 activates. Select the range that online shopping is in it, comma. For criteria 3, you need to select a cell that contains the online text or type it in the formula directly. I type online and press enter. But there is a problem. Remember, if you want to type your criteria directly inside the formula, you have to put it between two quotations. Now, if you look at the list, every item calculated correctly. And you can see that we didn't sell any male underwear online in UK. Question: can I, instead of writing online as new criteria, type it here and select this range as criteria? No, you can't do that. If we selected the range of these countries as criteria, it was because they all were in one column, but online is in a separate column and you need to define new criteria for that. In this section, I want to calculate the summation of each item for each country. First, I need to type each item in here. So what we have in the list, we have a scarf, pants, shirt, but no, don't do that. This list is short and you can find the items fast. But what if you had a long list and finding items was hard? The better solution for that is the unique function. The unique function returns a list of unique values from a list or range. I type equal unique and I select the items list and press enter. But there is an error, a spell error. This error happens when something is blocking the return array. If I select the spell cell, you can see the return array. The blue border is your return array. And these cells are blocking it. So if I delete them, you can see the unique items from the list. Let me change this cell's color. Now let's get to the formula. I type equal sumifs. I want to calculate the summation of this range, comma. My first criteria are in this range, comma. And these cells are all my first criteria, comma. The second criteria are in this range, comma. And I select these countries as my second criteria and press enter. Excel automatically calculates the sale amount for each country for each item. Isn't it awesome? The function is simple, but it is very practical. For the last step, let me show you a tip. We usually calculate the total like this. Equal summation of this range and drag it to these cells. And again, equal summation of this range and drag it to these cells. But there is a faster way. Let me press Ctrl Z to undo that. For calculating the total in both directions, you just need to select the range, including the total cells, and press Alt Equal. The total cells calculated correctly. Alright, now that you know how to use the SUMIF function, you can use other formulas of this family, which include AverageIF and AverageIFS, COUNTIF and COUNTIFS, MAXIFS and MINIFS. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. I see you in next video.